Today, I want to show you how to present your PowerPoints like a pro in Microsoft Teams, and it's not by using share screen. I still see a lot of people when they're presenting PowerPoints in Microsoft Teams just go and share a window. So they go up here, click share, and they see their PowerPoint on one of these and they share it from there. There's a much better way to do this. When you share the way I'm about to show you, you're going to get this view right here where you're going to be able to see all the people that are in it. You can see the chat. You can quickly change through views and see what you need to see. And then you can just go through your slideshow and mark it up as needed. Let me show you how you set this up using PowerPoint and Microsoft Teams. I want to show you three different ways to present your PowerPoints in Teams so you can choose what works best for you. I'm just in one of my demo teams here and I'm going to go and start a meet now. So you can go through setup just like normal. You pick your background, pick your cameras and mic and so on. I'm just going to click join now and I'm going to go and add a participant just so we have one in here, and then I'm going to show you their screen so you can see what's happening on their end. So I'm going to request them to join, so they'll just get an invite, and I'm going to accept it on my other screen and click join now. So this person has been added. So that this is just a normal part of doing a Teams meeting. But what I want to point out here is if we look at share, and like I said, a lot of people just want to share their PowerPoints through their screen. Keep moving down here. You're going to see different PowerPoint Live options. And these are saved in my OneDrive here. I can open them up from here. So I'm going to choose this one here. And you're going to see now, and I'm going to stretch out this window so you can see things a little bit better so things aren't so squishy. You can see how everything adapts. I have the person who joined up here. You can see I'm in the presenter, but I can also change quickly if I wanted to see the chat on the side, or even if I want to see someone raise a hand, I can see that pop up. If Ashton here would raise his hand, I would see that as well. So this makes things much easier to navigate. Now, I want to point out a couple things down below. You can navigate through your slideshow here just by moving it forward. You can see how it changes, and I will show you the other slide or the other screen in a moment, but I also want to show you how you can display. So if I click this, you can see all the different slides. You could go to this way, you could jump ahead. If I go to the more actions, I can go to show presenter view, and then I can jump ahead to different slides as I need. We have the tools here to increase font size. If I had any notes, all the notes would be right here. So it makes it incredibly easy to read your notes. You're presenting, you have your PowerPoint. If you want to mark up anything, you can draw, you can highlight all the way through here. So what's the other person seeing right now? Let me just grab their screen and bring it over to you. So I'm here on the side, so they're seeing me because I have my camera on and that's part of it. And here's the markup. Notice here that I can move it forward as a participant. If I go back to mine here, I can go to private view. And at this point, you can stop the people from moving the presentation on their own. So if I click that and bring this back over, notice now I can't do that. So that's an important thing. If you don't want people to jump ahead, make sure you have that turned on. And just looking at all the different options that you have from your layout, you have right now we're doing content only. Notice there's Cameo, and I want to show you how you can add a Cameo to your slide. And this is an interesting way to have yourself embedded into your slide, and I'll show you that in a moment. But let's show you a different way you can present your PowerPoint. Let's go ahead and just stop sharing on this PowerPoint that I showed you how to set up, and I'm going to click it again, stop sharing, and you can see it just goes back to the normal meeting. Now, this next time, what I want to do is present right from PowerPoint. So if I go over to a PowerPoint here, notice up top here, present in Teams, and I am using Microsoft 365. That's the subscription I have and the PowerPoint that I use. I can click on present in Teams. Now, you do have to have this saved in the cloud to have it work. If you don't have it saved in the cloud, when you click on this, it's going to tell you to save it in the cloud. But in my case, I do have this one saved in the cloud. So since I already had this meeting open, I can go ahead, once I clicked on it, and click present from here, and it's going to go to PowerPoint Live. So now I have this power. I went right through PowerPoint and clicked on that present in Teams, and it quickly got me there as well to the same place. Just make sure that you have your Teams meeting open to do this. Now, the last thing I want to show you is the Cameo. And I'm just going to click stop sharing again, stop presenting, and I'm going to go back to the PowerPoint here. So what a Cameo does here is I can add a place where I can have my video in here. So just rather than off the side, like in a normal Teams meeting, I can place it inside the PowerPoint. Now to do this, I can go Cameo for one slide or all slides. So I'll just do a couple as an example. So if I pick this slide, the Cameo is right down here. So I can move this around. I can size this. I can apply styles. As I hover over these, you can see what each of these will do. Now you can do a preview in here. If you have multiple cameras, if I go up to the top, you can see I have two different cameras. So if I pick Insta360 here, I have this camera showing me how it will be in the preview, and I can still go through and size it. So then I could pick, let's say slide 3, and I could add another Cameo to it. So under the record, I could go, again, I could go all slides, but if I go this slide, I could also use the designer. So I can take a look at the ones that they kind of recommend. And if I click this one, I have this in place right here. So I could go through and do more. I'm just going to keep these two here. So now if I go back and present in Teams here and click present, you're going to see that when this opens up, since the Cameo's in there by default, and I'll just stretch this out so you can see more options under the layout, I'm under the Cameo. So if I go ahead a couple of these slides here, you'll see on slide 3, I have the other Cameo in here as well. So that just gives you a different option to play around with how you want to present your Teams and how you want people to see you in there. So I hope you like these tips about how to present PowerPoint in Microsoft Teams to make sure you get looking as professional as possible. Thanks for watching this time on Teachers Tech. I'll see you next time with more tech tips and tutorials.